Start the lecture soon. Just start on the camera. You for I'm still waiting for the others to turn on their camera. Morning, and I'm sorry that due to unforeseeable circumstances, we could not have synchronous online class last week, although I already planned for that. That's okay. Now, we will have break, Easter break. Wednesday, but before the midterm exam, I think we still have one more class. So I will postpone the midterm exam explanation for that last lecture after the Easter break. Okay. But in general, my exam will not be a sit-down exam. I mean, it will be type of take-home exam. So I will give you the problems for you to work on, and then you submit it. You don't have to sit in front of computers at the time of exam. And you will have more than 24 hours to work on the answer, okay, not 2 hours like regular exam. Okay, so you will have plenty of time to work on that problems and submitting it. So for examples, if the exam is on Tuesday 10 a.m., I will release the problem on Monday 10 a.m. and I will give you until 12 p.m. on Tuesday to work on the exam answer. Will give you like 26 hours to work on. Okay, so more than 24 hours. I think that's enough. Okay, so it will be some kind of essay that you need to answer and using all the resources that you can get to answer the question. Okay. Now, today we will discuss database management system. Okay. So, database is we will discuss what's the definition later. But database is a record of all the data required by any institution, any organization, even any individuals to work or to conduct their day, routine activities. For examples, on you, I believe you have a database, even though it's called personal database. What's the example of that? Your address book in your mobile phone. It will contain the name of your contact, your friend perhaps, or their phone numbers, their email, their social media ID perhaps, and everything. Okay. And then another examples of database. Every time you conduct transaction in your bank account, the bank will record that transaction, and all the transaction will go into database. Even with journals, accounting transaction, for examples, it will go through. It will go to the database. If you look at later, the form or the appearance of database, it's always in form of table. And if you remember, general ledger, it also in a form of table. So that's why accounting records from manual accounting records and transform into digital one using computers, it's very easy because it has similar form, which is table. Okay. So why or what kind of information can be gathered from this database? Okay, let me show you this example. Okay. Okay. So take a look at this, the one in the middle. Can you see it? Let me see if I can expand this. Oh, unfortunately, it's not. Okay, so this is database. Okay, change to this. This is database. This is an example of database. So this is database. Okay. This is a simple record of breast cancer patient. Okay. This is a record from a research conducted by oncologists, doctor that specialize in cancer, for all the patients that suffer from breast cancer. From this information, I don't know what the meaning of its data, but from all this data that collected by oncologists over the years, people or doctors cannot predict whether or not a patient will develop breast cancer long before it's getting worse. Okay, so that's breast cancer, and it was done by just recording every incidence or every diagnostic that lead to breast cancer. Okay. Another example. I believe you already familiar with marketplace. Okay. So for example, Jessica, do you use marketplace frequently? Jessica? Jessica Natalia Gozali. Okay. You familiar with marketplace, right?
Yeah.
Hmm?
Yes.
Okay. What marketplace that you frequently visited and having transaction?
Supermarket?
No, marketplace, electronic marketplace.
Shopee.
Good. Okay, Shopee. What kind of device you use to access Shopee?
Handphone.
Your mobile phone. Good. Okay, so you installed Shopee application in your mobile phone?
Yes.
Okay, good. Okay, thank you, Jessica. So, with a marketplace application or any application, in fact, like Shopee, Tokopedia, even Google, even what else? Games, Instagram, TikTok, and a lot of other application. They are not only recording transaction, because in TikTok, what kind of transaction that TikTok have with you? Almost nothing. Okay. You don't buy anything, they don't sell you anything, they just show you commercial, for example, or advertising. So TikTok and any other social media in the world will collect the data, and that's also include Tokopedia, Shopee, Bukalapak, and any other marketplace application that you are familiar with. The moment you installed and open that application, then the application will, or the provider, Facebook, TikTok, and so on and so forth, will start to record the data. For example, with Jessica, anytime Jessica open Shopee application, it will be recorded. Shopee will record it. Oh, Jessica open this Shopee, or visit Shopee, or opening Shopee application from where? Indonesia, perhaps Jogja, or any other cities. What kind of device Jessica use to access Shopee? Laptop with browser or application installed on mobile phone? What kind of mobile phone? iPhone, Samsung, Galaxy Note, Galaxy S, or Xiaomi, or any other devices? Which type? The screen size, the battery size. Is there any other application? It will be recorded. What time? When Jessica visited Shopee, which category Jessica browsed first? What the products that Jessica usually purchase from Shopee? When Jessica usually purchase from Shopee? In the morning, while sitting in accounting information system class? In the afternoon, while having lunch, or late night, just before Jessica goes to bed? All those information are recorded by the application that you use, even location. Okay. So how, or what the purpose of this recording? All those application will use that information collected from us, the user, for commercial purposes, to make money. Okay. Google and Facebook, for example, Instagram and TikTok as well, will use that information to determine what kind of advertising will be displayed to you. So for example, for me, I don't have any TikTok account at this moment. I was tempted to have, but don't think I can handle it. Tokopedia, for example. Okay. Have you ever had this experience where you use your mobile phone to search something on Google? Say, the other day, I was, because my wife's car battery start thing to show the sign of it's starting to show the sign that it need to be replaced. Okay? So the battery getting weak. So I went online on Google and try to find out what kind of car battery, apart from the original battery that came from the car manufacturer, that I can buy. Is there any cheaper alternative to car battery? in bahasa Indonesia you probably ever heard Kawi. So I will not go for Ori, but I'll try to find Kawi version because it's usually cheaper. Okay, that's fine. I couldn't find what I was looking for. However, when I open kompas.com, immediately all the advertising inside that application showing me battery, car battery. Even though I didn't open kompas.com to find battery, I opened kompas.com to read news. That's the use of database. Okay. And that's a lot of things that can be done using database. Starting from small things like your address book, contact list, shopping list perhaps, up until the one that being used by the tax office, Indonesian tax office, for optimizing tax revenue. For example, finding whether or not somebody try to hide their taxes or avoid paying taxes or manipulating their tax report. There are a lot of things that can be done, and you will be amazed on how powerful accounting in this part. Remember the basic accounting equation? Assets equal to what? Capital and liability, right? I don't know the exact term, but yeah, that's the basic. And that's very powerful. All the tax officer will use that to find whether or not somebody hide their taxes or avoid paying taxes. Okay. Fraud also can use that fraud investigation can also use this kind of database to find out. Even when I was working for the government, with the consultant as for government institution, they develop fraud detection system. And fraud detection system is basically just looking at the database and finding abnormalities. Okay. Continue that later. Okay, so this is like the database that about cancer. It's very common. Let's start the topic for the materials for today. Okay. Database management system. So, remember that in accounting information system, every time an event, economic event occurs, we capture the data. What are the minimum data to be collected or being to be stored is who, the actor, who conducting the event, who responsible for certain action, who involved in transaction, what kind of asset being affected by this transaction, is there any change in cash because of we receive cash, is there any change in inventory because we sold that inventory, where the location is very important, especially if the location will have impact on the value of transaction, for example tax. If the transaction occurs in Indonesia, it will be bound by Indonesian tax law or Indonesian tax code. But if the transaction happen overseas, Indonesian tax code will have no jurisdiction over that. When you, I think you already familiar with the concept of when in accounting, especially with accrual basis. When, so you receive the money now, but you could not record this money received as revenue yet, because you haven't delivered the product, for example, or you haven't fulfilled your obligation. So that's where. Now, data can be aggregated to meet user requirements. For example, a manager might want to know how much total sales they made in a day. Did they achieve their target or exceed target or could not achieve the target? If they could not achieve the target, why? Who or which product could not sold to achieve the target? Who's the, from all those salesperson could not achieve their target? Why? So this kind of information required by organization on daily basis. Even in some cases, it will be required on hourly basis or even second basis. So this is for examples. The physical processing of delivery. Yeah. So the product delivered to customer, then customer will open the invoice, enclose, and pay. So this is record customer order data from delivery, record goods shipment data, record invoice data, and record receipt of payment. Okay, this is another physical processing, and this is information about bill, okay, record service provided, record billing data, record receipt of payment. So that's the difference between information processing and physical processing. When you hand it over the product to your customer, you also create an information or data to be recorded. Okay. When did you hand it over the product? Where? And the customer, where could be make difference? When the customer pick up the product from your office, for example, or from your shop, or from your warehouse, they didn't need to pay you delivery fee or transport fee. Okay. But when you deliver the product from your warehouses, from your shop to the customer's address, customer place, then they have to pay for transportation fee, delivery fee, things like that. So that's the difference. Okay. How we manage data files? If you remember your introduction to information system course, data starting from character. This is a basic unit of data. It could be letter, number, any special character, exclamation point, things like that. And then field is a collection of related character. For example, name, address, date of birth. Okay. Or records a collection of related data fields. So, your name, your address, your date of birth, your gender, and your student ID. When we put that all together, create a record of you. Okay. Collection of related records. We have a file here called students file. It records all the data related to students. We also have a file called lecturers. It has a collection of all records about lecturers. So when we look at, this is for example, customer record. So field is customer number, customer name, customer address, credit limit, salesperson, sister, year-to-date sales. And all the field regarding one particular customer will be called record of that customer. For example, customer number one, Samiaji, address Babarsari, credit limit 5 million, salesperson. A, sales territory Yogyakarta, year to date sales 10 million, that's for me. Customer number two, another person, customer number three, another person. Okay. I'll skip this. So, we also. So, all the database will have a form like this one. Okay. With this box, each box called a field, and all the data below this will called the record. Yeah. All database will be shown as a table with columns and row. Columns will be called field and row will be called records. Okay, so database will decouple data from application. I'll explain to you later. Okay, and it can be shared. Students' data is shared among many applications. For example, I have application to record your attendance. It's called as PKP. You have application to that show you your attendance. It's called Siagma. Both application using the same students' database. And when you pay your tuition fee, you also use students' database. Okay. So data can be easily accessed by report generator, and we will have ability to find what data we need from a database using a facility called Query. I'll explain to you later. So what is database management system? Database management system is a set of integrated programs designed to simplify the task of creating, accessing, and managing a database. Okay. What's the database management system function? First, defining data. You create the data. You create students file. You create students record. You create student data. Finding the relationship among data. For example, how many students in a class? How many lecturers can teach one students? How many advisor, academic advisor you have? How many advisee that I have, things like that. So that's relation. Interfacing with operation and mapping is user view of the data through schema. Schema is a description of the configured record types and data items and relating relationship among them. So this is the, will not bother you with this. So this is schema. Okay. So this is one file or one table of customer. This is credit department and this is sales manager. Okay, so this is database, a table with field, and rows. So this table called customer, this table called inventory item. Okay, customer have how many field? Anybody want to answer how many field this customer table had? Any volunteer want to answer this? Should I call your name to answer? No volunteer. Okay. Jonathan Reginald.
Sir.
Yeah. How many field customer database? Customer table head. How many field?
Is it seven?
Yes, it is seven. So field is the column. Okay, the column. The title of that column, this one, that here, is called field name. So this is the field name, cast code, it means customer code. The field, this field name is cast name, customer name. This field title is cast city, customer city. This field name is salesperson, this is sales territory, this is credit limit, and this is sales YTD sales year to date. So this is the column or field, and the top row is the field name. Okay, good. Maria Putri Bintang.
Yes, sir.
Okay, how many record customers table have?
Record customer.
Yeah, so this is the table customer here. How many record does it have?
Five.
Good, five. So record is the row. Okay. This row belong to bikes, etc. The second row belong to inter-bicycle sales. The third row belong to road bike and moped, so on and so forth. Okay. And this is their code. Okay. If you look at the tables, okay, you'll see that the first field in these two tables have different background color compared to the other. This one has gray, while the other have white. Okay, why? This part, or this field, the first field, not necessarily always the first, but usually it was placed on the first to simplify and to make reading the table easier. It's a field called identifier or primary key. Okay. Identifier or primary key. What's the function of this? Identifier field or primary key field is the identity of each record or row. This is to differentiate between bikes, etc., and stands, cyclery. Why? Because there is a good chance, and I've seen this many times, there are data that similar, quite similar, between row number one and the other row. For example, a few years ago, I had in my class a couple students that they are twins, identical twins, similar in facial features, and also similar name. The only difference is one student's name is Anna and the other name is Annie, but they have similar first name, Juliana and Juliani, and the same exact last name. I can't remember what's the last name. They had the same address. They are twins. They have the same date of birth. Okay. Very similar name, only different in one letter, Anna and Ani. Okay. So for database, computers, to be able to differentiate which one is Anna, which one is Annie, we need to assign identifier. Okay. I'm sure plenty of other people will have name Jessica, for example, or Pierre, or Samyaji, perhaps. Okay. I've seen few people have Samyaji as part of their name. Okay. So, how to differentiate between one Samyaji and the other? And remember, we don't have, computers doesn't have human capability to differentiate. Even when I saw the twin students in my classroom, I could not tell which one is which one is Anna, which one is Annie, because they are so similar. Okay? And if you don't see the face of the students, how could you tell which one Anna, which one Annie? Just by looking at their information, their data. Computer could not do it, So we need to assign a unique field that will differentiate between one row to the others. Okay. Okay. Now, let me ask you, Vincentius Renault. Is Vincentius here? No. Vincentius? Okay. Vincentius.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay, can you hear me? It's so your voice is so small. Can you get close to the mic, please? Okay, I'll ask the other student while Vincentius. You still owe me an answer, Vincentius. Okay, Gladys.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, can you think of any data about you that's so unique that no other person, even with the same name Gladys Nuritasari, will have? Any data at all about yourself?
About the name or the other thing?
Anything. Well, I believe there are plenty of other people will have Gladys name as their name, Nurlita as their name, Sari as their name. But what differentiate you and other people that's so unique that no other people will have that uniqueness? Remember, we talk about data, okay? What other feature that Maybe. Will be so unique that only you have that?
Maybe the face. Or I just
okay. Okay. No. Yeah. Computer could. Well, yes, computer can identify face, but that's not why. That's not the one that I would. Okay. But yeah, face could be unique, but it's very difficult for computers to differentiate one face to the other. And you'll be surprised that computer could probably find another person that look just like you. That's a possibility. Okay. Vincentius, are you ready? Vincentius?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, the same question as Gladys. What's data that's so unique? It's only you have that data, not the other. No idea.
Password?
No, not password. I guess password could be similar, just nobody. Okay, let me ask you. Vincentius, where are you now?
I'm in the radar.
Okay, no, I mean home, office, cafe or something? Home, okay. Can you get your KTP? Don't show it to the class, just get your KTP. Do you have the KTP with you? You have KTP, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay, you have your KTP?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Is there a number there that's, I think it's 16 digit, call NIK?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's the one. So NIK is an, because the citizen of Indonesia, Indonesia have more than 200 million resident or citizen. Okay. And even though we always think that ourselves unique, in the eye of systems or computers, we are not that unique. Gender, there are only two official gender in Indonesia, male and female. Date of birth, how many people have the same date of birth? Address, if you live in kos-kosan, you have plenty of people that has the same. Or if it's your sibling with your family, you live in the same address. Okay, so the government then create an IKA for identifying the Indonesian citizen. From the moment you were born and your parent registered your birth, you will be assigned an IKA. That's so unique that only you had that and nobody else. Okay? And IKA is actually quite unique. You know that I can tell from an IKA whether you are female or male just by looking at the NIK, not by looking at the photo on your KTP, not by looking at the name, just NIK. It's very possible. Well, it's not very possible. It's possible. I can tell your gender. Okay. And date of birth. Okay. Lovely, Devina Putri.
Yes, sir.
Do you remember your NIK or do you have your KTP with you?
I need to get my KTP.
Okay, please get your KTP. I would like to show the class something. So in NIK there is a small feature that could identify the date of birth and the gender of the holder.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. can you tell me for the digit 7 and 8 of your NIK, just the digit number 7 and 8.
4 and 5.
4 and 5. Okay, so, without looking at the months, your date of birth is 5, right?
Okay. That's right, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now, if you look at NIK and you see the digit number 7 and 5, it will tell you two things, the gender and the date of birth. For all female, the digit number 7 and 5, number 7 and 8 will be their date of birth plus 40. So in case of Devina, since her date of birth is 5 plus 40, it will be 45. My 7 and 8 digit is 04 because I was born on the 4th of something. Okay, so with male, digit 7 and 8 will be less than 40. With female, digit 7 and 8 will be more than 40. So, okay, let's get back to database. Okay, so you can see that's how this identifier, since it's very hard to find something that you were being born with that's so unique. Name could be unique, but there's also a name that plenty of other people have. For example, in Indonesia, perhaps Sri, Sari, Budi, Bambang is a common name. In the Western world, probably Joe, Smith, Joanne is very common name. So name is out of the question. Name is not unique enough to identify one person from the others. Address similar. Okay. Date of birth, 100 and even 1,000 of people could be born on the same date, same exact date. So the government have to create a unique identifier, this one. Okay. So that's for us. So identifier could be single column like this, or could be multiple. This is two. Okay. Why? Because one is not enough. One is not unique enough. It need two column to be very unique. Okay. It need two. Sometimes it needs three. Okay, but rarely more than that. Usually one is unique enough, two is quite unique, three very unique, but more than three usually is not advisable. You need to find another way to create identity. Okay, so that database. The advantage of database, I think you all find this in remember the introduction to information system class. It's non-redundant. You only have one data centrally stored and managed. Okay, so there is only one single version of information. Let me tell you the story that we had many years ago when Atma Jaya was still, well, it was my early day as lecturer, so it's more than 20 years ago. I've been lecturer like 23 years in Atma Jaya, so it was long time. You don't even born yet at that time. Okay, so in the old days, every year, the faculty, our faculty, have difficulties. What the difficulties? We could not tell with accuracy how many new students we will have that year. New student means the new class for that year. So it's just like you last semester. Okay. How many new students admitted to the faculty? Why? From accounting point of view, new students equal to revenue. So if we have, at that time, we could have three different versions of new student numbers. Version 1, version 2, and version 3. Which one is the right one? And you notice, in, from accounting perspective, accurate numbers is very important. Because the faculty need to record how much they made this year from the new students. How much we get from SPU, for example. 100 students, for example, there are three versions. Version 1 say 200 students. Version 2 say 240 students. Version 3 say 215 students. So which one's the right one? We couldn't tell. And these three numbers came from three different sources at the university level. Okay. So we could not tell which revenue. Is it 240? Is it 215? Is it 200? Which one? Okay, if one student contributed 10 million rupiah, you can tell how much difference between one version to the other. Okay, quite significant. Okay. The next, the class to be offered. You know that for first semester and even second semester, like you will get the package, right? So on your first semester, you will get this. Many classes. So the faculty have to prepare. For example, say that one class consists of 40 students. Okay, if the version that write is 200 students, the faculty only need to prepare 5 classes. But if the version that write was 240, then the faculty have prepared 6 classes. Okay. So which one is correct? If we prepare 205 classes, but the correct number was 240, 6 classes, there are 40 students will not get class, right? And that could be disaster. 40 students without class, it's a recipe for chaos. What if we prepare 6 classes, but then we realize that 200 students actually the right one? So we only need 5, but we prepare 6. That's another problem. You probably remember or know that sometimes we ask lecturer from outside this faculty or from outside Atmajaya to teach a class or two, right? And that's not easy. We have to persuade the external lecturer to be able to teach in Atmajaya. And that's not it. We have the external lecturer, they have to set aside special schedule for teaching at Atmajaya. They probably have to calculate how long does it takes to travel from their office to Atmajaya. And they have to ask permission from their employees, their university. And that's not easy. So we put that external lecturer on the 6th class. Okay. But we only need 5, not 6. So there will be 1 classes empty without students. What happened? We persuade this lecturer, the external lecturer already go through so many troubles to ask permission, to set aside schedule, and then to travel to Atmajaya just to find out that, sorry, your class is canceled. Can you imagine the problem that will be created by those kind of misinformation? Okay, the relationship between Atmajaya and the university and also that particular lecturer will be sour. And that's bad for Atmajaya's public image, and rightfully so, okay, if that's the case. So even with internal lecturer, okay, every semester the lecturer will set aside a schedule dedicated to teach a class. So I've been having this. So I like to arrange my classes from Monday to Wednesday, session 1 and session 2. Okay. And I build my schedule around that. However, it's often that, for example, all my class on Monday was canceled. So 2 classes on Monday canceled, so I don't have any classes on Monday. That will create a problem for me in my scheduling because I need to find something to replace that. Okay. And that's also a problem for many lecturers because teaching equal to revenue. Right. So that's why information, accurate information is very important. Okay, and that's where this database single version of information came in handy. Okay. Maintenance, because it's centralized, it's one place, you don't need to go. Reduce storage costs. Redundant data means you have copy of different data in different places and different storage media. And it means that you wasted space. Okay. Reduce storage costs, data integrity, because there's only one single version of information in data. You can trust that data. Okay. It can be shared, it's flexible, and it's secure because there's only one place to have the data. So how to create or how to develop a database? First, we need to identify what it's called as entity. Entity is everything that an organization would like to keep a record on. For example, inventory. Inventory is something that any companies would like to record. You know, they want to know how many or how much inventory they had. how many let me sorry could we have like 5 minute breaks? Okay, I need to take care of something. Okay, 5 minutes. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, there was an emergency. Okay, where were we? Okay, so entity. Okay. So inventory, for example, say entity, because we want to record the inventory number, the inventory amount, the value, the inventory movement, when it was added, when it was decreased, increased, things like that. Okay, another examples. If you go to the bank or any business, and you probably see a lot of trees. So is that trees entity? Usually not. If you go, you probably haven't go to campus lately, but if you go to our campus, there are plenty of trees. That's real trees. Just as real as the building, as real as the desk, chairs, computers, students, lecturers. But that those trees are not entity. The university does not record them because those trees are having no value for the university. I mean, yes, it has value, but from a system point of view, that there is no value. So that's entity. Students, lecturers are entity. Classes, subjects are entities. Okay. Each entity has attribute. Okay. And there is attribute is the field. Okay. So if entity is the table, attribute is the field, and then key attribute is the identifier or primary key field, and there is a composite attribute. So for example, the entity is client. It has attributes client number, this is the identifier, the primary key, name, address, contact person, phone number. Address itself has attribute composite of four different attributes: street address, city, state, and zip code or postcode. Each entity will have relationship with other entities. Okay. So for example, this employee has manager and admin staff. Yeah. Work completed, client works for this one, employee and supervisor. Or employee and work completed, things like that. Students and their academic advisor, lecturer and their advisee, the students, the manager and staff, and so on and so forth. Okay, so this example of that. Okay, stop here. And for our classes, we will use Microsoft Access. Okay, so I'll demonstrate to you now. Can you see this? Oh, sorry. Okay, Microsoft Access. Okay, so this is Microsoft Access. Okay, so every time you start Microsoft Access, you will have this. Okay. It has database, playing database, and any other template that it could be. They have nutrition tracking, task management, event management, students, context, asset tracking, so on and so forth. But we'll start with blank database, for example. Okay, so this is blank database. Okay, let me share you this. So this is the basic structure of a database, especially using Microsoft Access. So we have database here. Okay, inside this database, we will have tables. One table for one entity. And each tuple will have field. Field is the attribute of that entity. So if it's students, it has student ID, name, address, date of birth, place of birth, and so on and so forth. If it's lecturer, similar, but instead of student ID, it will have employee ID, okay. So on and so forth. So this is the database. This is, where is the access? is the this one. Yeah, this one. Okay, let me close this. So, oops. Okay, I'll start again the database access. Okay. So this is this part is this. Okay. So whenever we build a database, the first time that we need to create is tables. Okay, tables. So this is one table. So for example, this is already here. Just right click and go to design view. Table name, students. Yes?
I think you...
Okay, yeah, sure. Okay, sorry. Thank you. I'll share it. Okay. Okay. Sorry about that. So I'll start from okay, so this is Microsoft Access with create blank database. Okay. So this is table, the first table. Whenever you start Microsoft Access with blank database, it will start table, but we will not use this table. Okay. Because it only have one field, okay. So we right click the table one name here, and then goes to design view. Say for example, student. You'll see this part. So we have to create the field first. We have to define the top of the field. Okay, the top of the column, the title of the column, that's field. Okay, so student ID, and this is auto number. Auto number means that when you add new student, it will automatically get new ID. Okay, we will see that later. Full name. Sorry. Full name. It will be short text. And the field size here, remember because this is auto number, different from short text. Short text means that say how many characters in a name, say 100. Okay, so then date of birth. Here is the date time. Okay, so that's it. We can close this, save, okay. Can open it, see the table. So let's see if we can fill it. Another, see, when I add new students, here, say, it's immediately the student ID showing number 2. Okay. And when do I put another name, a similar name? Okay. It will be different from the first line.
I'm
sorry.
Sir, I'm sorry to interrupt, but you're not share screen to us. The share screen is not shown. Yes.
Really?
The PowerPoint or the application.
Okay. Let me see. Okay. Can you see it now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The others? Okay. So, like I said, when I add the name here, even though it's the same as the other field, okay, it won't matter. Why? Because the first field here, the first column, they have different student ID. 1, 2, 3, 4. Samyaji number 1, Samyaji number 3, Saroso number 2, Saroso number 4. Although they have the same full name and the same date of birth, doesn't matter. Because the student ID are different. Okay. So, okay. Do you can you imagine any scenario that the student data is exactly the same, but they have different student ID, different NPM? Can you imagine scenario like that? Any idea? Can it happen? There are two students have the same name, the same address, the same date of birth, the same gender, but different NPM. Can you imagine something like that? Is it possible? Eleonora, is it possible to have two students that have the same name, the same address, the same date of birth, the same gender, and the same everything, but different NPM? Eleonora, Michelle, Wiharja, is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Because if the person is, because every person is a different person, sir.
Okay. Thank you. That's right. However, in Atmajaya, at least a few years ago, I don't know about now, it's possible. Now that this is your second semester counting, right? And you feel, this is too hard. I don't like it. I want to change to another program. For example, you move to management. Okay. Since you already passed the first semester, you already have introduction to accounting, introduction to business, introduction to information system, and so on and so forth. You want to move to management. Yes, I don't know about now, but it used to be possible. So you can move to management, and you carry on. You carried all the subject that you already, or the classes that you already passed, to management department. Okay. You will have the same name, the same grade for that subject, that five subject in the first semester. You have the same address. Just because you move to another program doesn't mean you have to move to another address. Date of birth, basically it's you. Okay. But for the system, you are two different person. Why? Because the student ID, your old student ID in accounting will not be erased. It will be there. You will be given a new student ID. Okay. So your old student ID will be retired and nobody can use it anymore. You will get new student ID. So it's possible that there are two students with different student ID, but the rest of them are the same. Okay, that's possible. It happened in the past. I don't know the regulation now about moving to another program, but it used to be able to do that. In fact, that was the tactic being used by some students. So some students, they will go into easier program to get into, you know, accounting is one of the elite program in Atmajaya. So getting into accounting is difficult compared to other. So till I will not say which program. So some students get into that program, and then after one semester, they apply for transfer to another. It's possible as long as it's still in the same university. That's possible. So they move from the old study program to accounting. Okay, and they can bring along some of the subject that similar that offered in the first semester in accounting. So yeah, that's okay. So even though the name, date of birth are the same for the database, those are different people because they have different ID. Okay. So this is the table, okay? And the table are here in the database. Okay. So what you see here, I enter the data directly into the table. In practice, that's a bad idea. When you see Hildegard Arnaldo Heri Kusuma. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. You remember my I was saying in earlier on this lecture that general ledger is similar to table, right?
Yes.
In the form. Okay. So if you have saving account in a bank, your money will be recorded using the same format, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. How many times did you use your account in the bank in a month? How many times?
Month, I will say like twice maybe.
Okay, twice. Have you ever directly enter the number into your table account?
No, I haven't.
No. What did you use to entering the data? Did you use ATM machine? Did you use internet banking, mobile banking?
I use the ATM machine.
Okay, good. Okay, so that's the practice. It is bad idea to directly enter the data inside a table. In every application, let me show you this. This one, database will be hidden from users. Okay, remember when I was talking about the cashier in the control, okay, internal control. User could not access this. It's very dangerous. Okay. Even I lecturer, when I submitted my grade, and then some student objected to their grades, and it was my mistake. I could not change directly here. I have to make a letter saying that this is a mistake, and this is the right one. Okay, so I could not alter or change the grade directly here, and that's always a bad idea. So in Microsoft Access, to enter the data, you will create a form or forms in plural, okay, forms. This is form is basically just like a form in real life, but instead of paper form in Microsoft Access, this is a electronic form. Okay, let me return to Access. Okay, can you see it? No? Okay, so what we need to create a form to enter the data. So here, create, and this is part, this part, forms. Okay. Can you see it now? Is it visible? Okay, I'll assume yes. So we can form, I'll use form wizard. Okay, so with form wizard, we have these three from the disabled student, which part that we will allow to be filled. Okay, so I'll select all. Okay, so the layout, it can be data set table, which it will be or columnar or justified. I'll select justified. Inform students. So this is it. Okay. So for example, okay. So it's next fourth. Okay. Okay. So add new, for example. New. Okay, are you not present? Date of birth, and select any date. Okay, just next. That's it. When we saw, when we open the tables, oh, it says Ariano here. Okay, I change the first name to Ariano, but I can add new examples. Date of birth. this. Okay. Wait, this. Sorry, this. Okay, so that's the form, okay? And then you will have query. Create report, for example. See? Okay. Oh, yeah, this is, it has to be refreshed before. So, this is the report. Okay, all the students. Okay. So, what does it mean? First, you, if in order to create an application with database, you create the database first with all the tables, okay? And then you create forms to fill out the database. And then you create report. With report, you can use query to filter out all the information that you don't want to appear in report. Report could be hard copy, printed out, or something that came up in the screen, or it's called soft copy report. Okay. For example, if you conduct internet banking, everything will be in soft copy. There is no hard copy available. So, when you transfer money using ATM, the database is in the bank. The ATM only have this, the form that you enter the transaction, and then the ATM will also give you hard copy report or soft copy report. The database itself and the query will be on the bank, inside the bank. Nobody can touch it unless they are authorized to do it. Okay, and that's for security. Okay, that's it for today, and I already give you a little bit of explanation on database using Microsoft Access. I suggest you to read books about Microsoft Access. And after the midterm exam, I'll give you the assignment on database. And similar to the previous, we will go step by step. Okay? Any question? No? Okay. That's it for today. Thank you for attending. Have a nice break and keep it safe and healthy. Okay? So see you after the break.
Thank you.